Welcome to the Strategic Plan Dashboard tutorial. The Countywide Strategic Plan includes 10 community outcome areas, each of which will have its own dashboard containing headline metrics visually represented to easily review the data that will continuously inform the strategic plan. The dashboards are interactive and enable the reader to access more detailed data and a narrative for context and clarity. Data will be reviewed and updated regularly to assess trends, inequities, and alignment with the strategies included in the strategic plan. The dashboards help to monitor progress over time and serve to inform and guide community leaders, practitioners, and advocates in making data-driven decisions, planning related strategies and programs, and prioritizing resources. In this video, you will learn how to navigate and use the dashboards. Let's start by exploring the county strategic plan and community outcome areas, which can be viewed by going to the website at www.fairfaxcounty.gov/strategicplan. Once on the page, you can scroll down and select Learn More to read about each outcome area. Let's select the button for Healthy Communities. You will now see the main page of the dashboard. Healthy Communities features two main pages, which include 15 headline metrics across both pages. The dashboard also includes detail pages for each of the headline metrics as well, which will be shown later. You may navigate to any page using the forward and backward arrow in the bottom section of the dashboard window, or by clicking on the 1 of 14 and selecting a specific page of interest. Each page on the dashboard will also include a button that takes you to the main page, the Data Notes page, or other pages that are relevant to the specific headline metric you are viewing. Users may zoom in and out of the dashboard by clicking on the plus sign or the minus sign. To return to viewing the full dashboard page, click on the Fit to Page icon found at the bottom right of the screen. Use the diagonal arrow icon to enter Full Page mode, which will fill the extent of the user screen. While in the full view mode, navigation to other pages of the dashboard is also found in the bottom section of the window. The Go Back link will take the user to the previous web page visited prior to accessing the dashboard page. To return to the previous view mode and see the contents of the web page, click on the icon with diagonal arrows pointing toward each other. Let's now discuss the main page in greater detail. The main page, seen here, is comprised of the headline metrics for this outcome area. Charts vary depending on the metrics, including line graphs and bar charts, for example. All charts will feature an axis representing a time frame. The 4-digit applies to a calendar year unless otherwise specified. In some cases, you will see an FY, which means the Fairfax County fiscal year, or a Q1, Q2, etc., which represents a quarter. While on the main page, you're encouraged to mouse over any data points of interest to view more information, such as the number associated with the percentage shown. Below most charts, you will see various types of icons. Mousing over the icons reveals their meaning in a small pop-up window. The first icon or text below each chart will indicate the trend. Icons with the arrows pointing up or down indicate that a trend is going upward or downward. A thumbs up or down inside arrow indicates that the trend is either desired or undesired. The color green indicates a desired trend, and red indicates an undesired trend. Let's navigate to the second main page of the Healthy Communities dashboard to cover additional information you may see on a main page. As you can see on main page 2, instead of up or down arrows regarding the trend, text may also indicate fluctuating if the data on the chart inconsistently change up and down from period to period, or stable trend if the data do not fluctuate or present minimal fluctuation from period to period. Definitions of these terms are included in the Data Notes page, which can be accessed by using this button found on the main page of the dashboard. Other content in the Data Notes includes important details about the data sources, additional terminology definitions, and links to other helpful resources. In addition to the trend icons or text, there is also an equity icon, which includes three persons of various heights. This icon means disaggregated data are available and featured in the detail page of that headline metric, such as by race, ethnicity, or geographic location. If this icon is not present, then no disaggregated data were available at the time of publishing. Let's return to the first main page to continue. We can do this by clicking on the button on the bottom right of the page, or by clicking on the arrow back. In addition to the main page or pages, there are detail pages for each headline metric. The detail page features the narrative, or story behind the numbers, as well as any available data disaggregated by demographics or by location. Let's look at two examples. For our first example, let's look at the uninsured residents under age 65 headline metric. As you can see, in most cases, a percentage or number will appear above a chart, whether it be a line, bar chart, etc. This is the figure for the most recent year of data applicable to the metric. You will also note that the line chart shows an overall downward trend for the years 2016 to 2022. Therefore, a desired downward trend icon appears below the graph. An equity icon is also present, indicating that disaggregated data are available on the detail page. To view the detail page for any headline metric, mouse over the title. A pointed finger and text that says, "Click here to follow the link," should appear. The detail page is now shown and includes summary bullets in the narrative box. Use the bar on the right to scroll down to see the full story. Information on the source of the data is included on each detail page. In this case, it is in the bottom left of the screen, although it may appear in other locations in other dashboards. The page includes multiple views of the uninsured data for various years, including data disaggregated by race, ethnicity, and sex, as shown in the charts on the top. The default view is percent. Click on the number button on the top to switch views from percent or vice versa. The bottom left chart includes data on the percentage of uninsured by age group, under 19, 19 to 64, and 65 years and older. The bottom right chart includes uninsured data by race and ethnicity by the same age groups. Now let's go back and look at another example from main page 2. On the second main page, we'll take a look at the headline metric, Adults Who Are Obese. You'll note a fluctuating trend due to the percentage increasing from 2018 to 2019, and then decreasing from 2019 to 2020. The equity icon is also present, indicating that disaggregated data are also available. Let's navigate to the detail page for more information by clicking the title. You will also find the narrative box on the left and the data source below. On the top right of the page are bar charts, which show the percentage of adults who are obese at the county, state, and national level. If you hover over the bars, you can see the number of adults who are obese. The bottom right chart shows data related to the headline metric, the percentage of kindergartners who are obese from 2016 to 2021. Lastly, the rates of obesity in Fairfax County are also available by census tract, as shown in the interactive map. Click on the plus or minus buttons in the bottom left to zoom in or out on the map. Click on the focus mode icon to enlarge the map. The darker shades on the map show census tracts with higher rates of obesity. Click on the map to see a pop-up, including the census tract and the prevalence rate. You can also explore more advanced map features by clicking on the icon on the top left with three horizontal lines. To hide the features, click on the same icon again. From this map view page, click on Back to Report on the top left side of the map window to return to the Detail page for this headline metric. Once on the Detail page, to continue to the main page of the dashboard, click on the Main Page 2 icon. We remind you to review the Data Notes page for additional details about the information presented throughout the dashboard. That concludes our tour of the Strategic Plan Dashboard. We hope this tutorial has given you a general understanding of the dashboard and the tools needed to explore and learn more about each of the 10 community outcome areas. Please note that the dashboards are monitored regularly and updated as needed, so over time, some features may look different than what is shown in this video. If you have questions regarding this dashboard, please send an email to dmbdataanalytics@fairfaxcounty.gov. Thank you for watching.